Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to make Nonesuch Kits, or my version of Nonesuch Kits. Someone requested that I do that, and it doesn't look like it's going to be that hard to do, so I'm going to go ahead and show you a version. It is definitely not the same as what we had at the Glitz because I've changed the flavor of ice cream. I'll explain that in a minute. What you need to do if you want to make this recipe is look at my previous upload in which I told you how to make meringue shells, because one of the important ingredients of this is a meringue shell that is freshly made. So we're starting with our freshly made meringue shells, and you can see what they look like in the pan. And I had a second pan, so I've taken one of those. It's light and airy and it's crispy. You can see on the bottom. That goes on the bottom, and also on the bottom surrounding it is hot fudge. Now I'm choosing a sugar-free variety. It's pretty hot because I put it in the microwave. You want this to be liquid, because if you just have it in your refrigerator, which is where I had mine, you can't get it to go around this circle. But I could probably pour this the way I have it now. So I just want to put some hot fudge sauce around. And it's nice to have it hot anyway, because we're going to be having ice cream, and the contrast of the hot and cold is very good. So I'm just trying to control this as it goes, about like that. And then what I want to do is sprinkle some almond slices, and I have them over here. Just a second, I'll be here with my almond slices. This was a package I already had open. You might want to toast these. If you like toasted almonds, then just spray a little skillet and put a few of these in and heat them, but don't let them blacken because they will be bitter and burned. But I'm just taking a few of these sliced almonds, and this is pretty much what I remember seeing and eating at the Glitz. So you just want to go around that edge on top of your dark hot fudge sauce and try to make the complete circle evenly. So I'm missing a few there and a few over here and back here. Now the next thing, it was stacked in layers, and the next thing is the ice cream. So I just have pint here of this is just a chocolate paradise. It's basically chocolate ice cream. And I will tell you that if you want the true Nonesuch Kits, it is mocha ice cream. I think they call it Jamocha ice cream. My husband does not like the coffee flavor at all, so we're substituting chocolate in the place. And I've already scooped out a scoop's worth of chocolate to go in that hollowed out center that you'll have of your meringue shell. Then next, what we're going to do is place some whipped topping over that. And this is just regular whipped topping. You can cut your calories a little bit here and there on this one, because you could get ice cream that is sugar-free or fat-free. You can get whipped topping that is a little different. That's just up to you, and I'm just using what I happen to have here at home. So on top of that, we're going to put some whipped cream. Maybe not too much, because it might just overpower the ice cream that's there. Just swirl it a little bit. And then on top of that, I didn't have any stemmed maraschino cherries. I just had whole ones, so I'm going to place the whole maraschino cherry on the top. And there is your Nonesuch Kits. Hope you like it.